We'll be right back. Thank you. shines eternal. Illusion shattered.
Let my name echo in song.
The Temple of Wisdom. Grow, grow, grow.
There is no escape.
Let's leave her alone.
Now you shall perish.
This realm is... you ever...
Don't blink! Woohoo!
the show begin.
Woohoo!
Off you go.
Let's dance!
Woohoo!
Be still.
Forget it.
寝坊でもしたのか。いや、そんなこと今まで一度もなかったし。来る途中ですれ違った可能性は。やあ。で、俺、なんでみんな心配そうな顔してるんだ。ニーローさんがまだ来ていないのです。え？ただの遅刻じゃないのか。それがちょっとおかしいんだ。
ニーローはいつも早めに来てた。それにセノがさっきグランドバザールに寄って彼女に声をかけようとした時、もうとっくに出かけたと言われた。
でセノは着いたのにニーローはまだ着いてないってわけか。はい、だから心配しているのです。あの日危険物を輸送するキャラバンを尋問したんだが、貨物が全て奪われた以上 物的証拠は何もない。それにこの件に関してはあいつらも被害者だからな。キャラバンは確かに怪しいが、盗まれた貨物を取り戻すまでは保護という名目で監視を続けるしかない。宝石についても売り手と連絡がついた。もう一つの宝石は砂漠で若い男が買っていったそうだ。
とにかく状況をまとめると、 危険物ともう一つの宝石の行方はわからず、ニーローがどこに行ったのかもわからないということだね。でもなんでニーローが巻き込まれたんだ？3つの出来事につながりがあるかどうかはまだわからないけどね。ただその方向で仮説を立てるなら、ニーローの家臣の舞は家臣探査への重要なプログラムだから、もし
相手の目的が家臣探査を めちゃくちゃにすることなら、ニーローがターゲットになる可能性は高い。旅人キャンディス、早速痕跡をたどろう。ティナリはパルディスディアンに残って他の奴が来たら状況を説明してやってくれ。
うん、単に急ぎの用事ができちゃったって可能性もあるしね。ここで待ってるよ。
まずはグランドバザールに行こう。ニーローがどこから出かけたか確認するんだ。僕が残るから安心して行ってきて。フェオチどこに行ったんだろう。
Yeah.
たち、どうしたんだ。
ニーローがどこに行ったかわかるか。
ニーロー、今日は友達の手伝いに行くと言って早くに出かけたが。
一人でか。どの門から出たか見なかったか。
ああ、一人だったぞ。そうだな、確か北門だったはずだ。
パルディスティアイとは真逆の方向だな。
何かあったのか。こんな肝心な時に冗談じゃないぞ。
ズバイルさん、もしニーローがグランドバザールに戻ったらパルディスティアイの者に伝えてくれないか。
ああ、まあ手が離せない用事ができただけだと思うんだが、とにかく早く向かってくれ。解決したら俺にも知らせてくれるか。
ああ、必ず。さあ行こう。北門を出て誰かに聞いてみよう。
Be on your way now. Don't waste any more time.
Hey! I hope nothing bad happened to her.
Miss Navita, have you seen Nilu this morning?
Nilu? Oh yes, I saw her head out of the city. She was wearing the prettiest outfit.
Which way did she go?
That way, I believe.
Was there anyone following her? Did everything look okay?
I mean, it looked like she was in a good mood. She even stopped to say hello. And no, I didn't see anyone else.
All right. Thank you.
It seems like freebies can really cause conflicts.
Excuse me. Have any of you seen Miss Nilu from Zubair Theater come this way?
Yes, General. I saw Miss Nilu cross the bridge after leaving the city this morning. There was a man waiting for her on the other side.
Wait, could that be the person who bought the second gem?
Did you see the man's face?
Unfortunately, no. He was too far away.
Understood. If she comes back this way, tell her to find me at Part East EI.
Yes, General.
Let's keep going. With this many traces, it's easy to get mixed up. Let me take a closer look. Sure. We'll continue analyzing the footprints over here. It's easy to get mixed up with this many footprints. We need to be thorough.
Did you see a girl walk by? Really? Which way did she go? A messy pile of rocks? Oh, that makes sense! Thank you, Arasaka. Arasaka, about the other thing you mentioned. Guess that ends this conversation. Well, let's tell Sino and Candace what we learned.
The Fane of Ashwata? Where did you get this information?
Information.
All right, I trust you. Another vision? Was Nilu one of the voices? Let's head towards the ruins for now. The vision could mean we're on the right track.
Thank you.
We should be getting close.
This area is usually full of treasure hoarders. Mew could be in danger. It's Nilu! Hey!
I don't think she can hear us. We're too far away.
Come on, let's go!
What are you doing here?
Can't we stick to one question at a time? Oh wait, that one doesn't count!
What dreadful cacophony! Are we not allowed a quiet place to practice?
Sarouche!
Ah, Pale Floater. And my Yasnapati!
You know this red floating being?
Excuse you! I, Sarouche, am a noble Pari, and the Bloom Guard of Quarina.
Sarouche is a Pari we met in the Vorukasha Oasis. She's really nice, you just have to get used to the way she talks. So you are the one who bought the other gem!
A Ouijat Eye Pari. Sounds like something I've read about before. Now's not the time for riddles. Everyone in the city is still worried about Nilu.
Message? What message?
Tell me Roshnu fell asleep halfway there. Again!
Oh, hearing that name, this is all starting to check out.
Who's Roshnu?
Hold on, let's take this one thing at a time. First, what are you guys doing here?
They're here!
I've had enough of these insufferable rascals! Wreaking havoc in the desert, right and left! Wake up, Roshnu! We need to teach them a lesson, or we'll never get another good night's sleep!
Trap them with my thorns when they pass by, and you can take care of the rest.
Perfect! They don't stand a chance! Let's give them a taste of sheer terror!
Uh.
What in the... thorns? Boss, the wagon is stuck!
Huh?
Now!
Don't get too low or they might see you!
Bombs! There are bombs falling from the sky! Ah! Stop panicking! Get the wagon out for...
So you're not entirely ignorant after all. Fine, I'm willing to call it a day. But if those scoundrels continue to disrupt the peace of this land, I will show no mercy!
Can get along with anyone, huh?
Sethos fulfilled his duty well. I have come here for a monumental task.
What task?
I heard Lesser Lord Kusanali is currently celebrating her birthday in the city. As her familiars, the Pari have decided to bestow upon her a special gift. As decided by Elder Zervin, the Bloomguard of the Pari, that would be me, will present the Dance of Sebzerus to Lesser Lord Kusanali, a tradition passed down over the centuries. Good thing I did. How was I to know the current version is nothing like the original?
Well, there are bound to be changes over the centuries.
I appreciated young Nilu's determination, so I invited her here to practice in peace.
Oh, so that's what happened. Feels like we've been chasing bad guys for days, but in the end, there were no bad guys at all. It was all for Nahida's surprise!
That would explain why they chose a remote path away from Aru Village. They're lucky you didn't catch them in the act.
Okay, remind Paimon not to get on Candace's bad side.
It was a gift from King Deshret to Lesser Lord Kusanali. I only know the basics. I never thought these two gems could be connected to the relic from the legend. But the Ouija-Dai was lost after the cataclysm in Kanria, buried deep beneath the sands.
And Lesser Lord Kusanali turned the Quarina into a divine bird, tasked with guarding the border between new birth and death, until the bird shattered into pieces and gave rise to the Pari.
So Candace actually saw things recorded by the Ouija-Dai.
Technically, the eye belongs to Lesser Lord Kusanali. Why don't you just give it back? Understand your reasoning, but if this is the decision of the group, as well as my Yasnapati, then I shall object no further. Well, are you going to let me teach the girl the dance of Sub-Zeros, or do you intend to drag this on incessantly?
She's got a point. Now that we know it was all a false alarm, let's go back and tell everyone what happened. They're probably worried.
I'll tell the other Matra to keep an eye out for that caravan. If we find evidence of any misconduct, we won't let them off lightly.
Focus! No more distractions! Now, follow along! Watch closely. One and two and...
いい。こう。そしてこうよ。こうして。こう。言ってあげて。僕がついてるからさ。
ウジャタの目に隠された歴史。
It was all just a misunderstanding. How are the preparations going?
I think I'll check it over later, though. We were so worried about you all, it was kind of hard to focus.
Great! We don't have to worry about missing the parade!
Actually, I have a favor to ask as well. These are the decorations for the flower carriage. Could you bring them to the sanctuary of Surasthana and hang them on the carriage? Oh, it would mean a lot to have the Knight of Flowers personally decorated.
You can count on us! We're done. Now we just have to go to the sanctuary of Surasthana and hang the decorations on the flower carriage. Huh. Wonder what the sanctuary looks like the night before the festival. Let's go check it out. Should be good. All we need to do now is wait for the parade tomorrow.
Are those Parisaras?
On that topic, I wonder how much it's worth. That's what I heard just now. Dear friends, a critical moment has arrived. It is time to come together and play genius in...
Well, that's also true. I have fond memories of my adventures with Pale Floater and my Yasnapati.
Really? Paimon's happy to hear that. It felt like this Sub-Zero's festival had surprises for everyone. When you called out the Arenara, Paimon nearly fell out of the sky in shock! No wonder Arasaka was so flustered. He was trying to keep it a secret! Oh, Paimon's sure everyone in Sumeru loved the surprise. It felt like a dream. Nahida?
Is reserved for the mighty Pari.
Paimon's the only one allowed to float next to him.
Ah,